Hey guys, OICOMS here, and welcome back to the AOR Season 12 Championship. We're here for round 15, the Singapore Grand Prix, as you can probably notice by the walls and the track itself anyway. The last two rounds we attempted were actually quite decent. Has been a while since I had two good races in a row this season, to be honest, and we tried to do that as well in this race here. Although, practice, well, this track is very, very difficult, of course, and I wasn't really that confident, especially not in qualifying, but here we go then, on the final lap. Currently I'm sitting on a 40.9, which is not really what I want to do, but having a decentish run through the first couple of corners, now coming into turn 4, which is a very, very crucial corner, especially the exit onto this straight here. And you can see on the delta there, which I again forgot to turn off before the actual qualifying session, we are currently 2.5 turns up on our previous best, but a tenth behind the flying fin in that first sector, which is quite decent. Into first gear here, into this hairpin, and a little bit too much over the curb here, which unsettled the car a little bit more than I wanted to. But now coming into the Singapore sling, which is new for this year, and also that invisible wall here on the left hand side, it has to be avoided, which is why I was maybe a little bit cautious and lost a little bit of time through this section here into the hairpin. Very, very slippery braking zone, and also here on the outside of the track, not really the best exit, so losing a little bit of time in that second sector after being almost full turns up, I think, in the middle of it. And now coming into the last sector, which I really enjoy driving, to be honest, on this track. And pretty much the same corners all over again, but not quite the same. This section here is very, very tricky under the hotel, clipping the apex here nicely. Little bit off the curb there, a little bit off the apex, and now in only four corners to go into this final chicane, short shifting into fourth, avoiding the wheel spin as much as we can. And now into the last corner, and we're gaining actually a tenth in that last couple of corners, which is not too bad. It's going to be a 40.4. That's okay in the end, to be honest. I was able actually to do 139, which was just before the session, but it was just miles better than all my laps I did during the week, really. So flying fin taking pole position, 44 thousandths of a second back front of CEO. So again, very, very close between those two. Then reversal surprisingly in P3 in front of Martin, then Hamilton, burnout, limitless, Alonso, and me then in ninth, Franglish and Raikkonen rounding up the first half of the field. Well, being the top 10, not too bad. I should mention, this is the first race on the Xbox platform after the tire glitch has been fixed. So you can see everyone qualified on the Ultrasofts finally again, which is, I think, very, very good. Jason in 12th, you can see there. Falcon Leo, but my teammates do finally attending a race again. And a lucky dog rounding up the, well, not the grid, but Andre and Mike actually still on the grid. But, well, you can see the strategy. You can see it is going to rain for the last third of the race, basically. And this is, could be very, very interesting towards the end of the race. I was planning a one stop anyway, going from the ultra softs to the softs, but maybe I will just do that pit stop a little bit earlier, because the drop off on the ultra soft is pretty huge. But you just try to stay out of trouble in these first couple of corners. We are here for the Singapore Grand Prix, round 15, 5 lights, and away we go. And we're having a terrible start. We're having actually the delayed lights for some reason. I'm not too sure why. It's not anyone there's not really anyone joining the session. None of my one. Anyway, we lost a number of positions. Actually, there's a contact between the Ferraris. I think Jason, I think it was, clipped the rear of Falcon, and that put him into the barrier together with Raikkonen. Very unfortunate for the Ferraris. But we actually only lost a position despite having the most terrible start since I don't know when, really. Stu up into 11th, so that's very, very good to see for my teammate. And no, and that is unfortunate. I was actually aware of that. This corner is very, 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 you know, typical, that people have to slow down way more, that you have to slow down way more than way earlier in the first lap than probably I did. But it still wasn't enough. I still hit the back of Falcon. And getting an orange front wing on the first lap is probably one of the worst things that can happen. Oh, well, if you get taken out, of course, well. But in terms of making your mistake, really, that will harm us hugely. Especially around a circuit like this, which just needs aerodynamics. Yeah, we will probably lose, I don't know how much I will lose. Maybe a second, 2 seconds per lap. So definitely, we are now very, very, very harmed in this first stint and probably have to do an early pit stop to avoid the time loss as good as possible and then hope that the rain doesn't come too late. But anyway, for now, we will continue and see how bad the damage actually is. Running a little bit wide here, you can get a 10-second penalty from that one. So we definitely have to be wary of that last corner. Especially with a broken front wing, you can see how much Falcon is pulling away in these corners. This is ridiculous how much time we already lost to the field ahead. And now it's probably going to be a train, pretty much, from us down into last place. Others than the Ferraris, who are actually now in the pits. And some other car, which I'm not too sure at the moment. But yeah, start not very good to this race. It is a long race, it's the longest race of the season, actually. It's plenty of time to recover, but I wasn't really that confident, to be honest, at this moment, because I knew pace was, average, ooh, to say the least, and now it's got even worse with the damage, with clipping the wall there, and, well, now we will definitely lose 2 seconds a lap or something. Oh, running wide here as well, almost hitting the wall there as well, so you can visually feel and see the understeer also through that hairpin here, and Leopold is right behind us, but we are having enough straight line speed to keep to hold him off. We're definitely not, well, we're definitely not fighting too hard, but we're definitely not trying to let these guys through, because, you know, these will be the guys who will be fighting probably afterwards anyway, when we pit early and get the front wing change and maybe getting an undercut. Maybe we have to overtake them again later in the race, so definitely trying our best here in with this broken front wing again, almost clipping the wall there, and probably we will lose now a couple of positions on the start finish, especially with this corner being a left hand double left hander. And look at this by Leobot, I would say. Here we go, is Leobot going up the inside here? He is attempting to, and we're not going to fight him too hard for that one. Nice move for him. And we probably let Stu, it will be probably the only car which we will let through, because, you know, teammate and stuff, and he hasn't had a good race since, I don't know, when, has been a while, I think Silverstone was his last decent race, really was Stu. And here we go then, we will go into the lane, we have keep the DRS open though, just slot in between him and Lucky Dog, clipping the rear a little bit of him, but nothing too major. Similar contact to Falcon, but we didn't get any damage from that one, surprisingly, but you know, that's how it is. At the end of lap 3, I thought I had enough, really. That damage is definitely not going to help us at all. Oh! That was close into the pit lane, to say the least, but we didn't get a drive through. Very, very, very lucky, to be honest, and we're now going onto the soft tyres and hope it will last until the rain. How much we probably expect the next guys to pit, I don't know, on lap 7 or something? Lap 8? Not too sure anymore, as STS have won. Alonso is retiring from the session. Oh yeah, he was the third guy actually, had to pit after the first lap. After a contact with, I forgot who it was, to be honest. But anyway, we are coming out in P17. In front, behind Jason, a little bit wider on the pit exit. Too major. So now the task is really to get into the rhythm and set consistent laps, and yeah, just see what we can do. Really, there's not much we can do. We're probably also relying on others' mistakes, which will most likely happen because this circuit is just so demanding, and this race is going to be so incredibly long. And yeah, Jason definitely now on the better tires and the super soft. The softs are actually not that quick around here, to be honest. But he actually made that pretty well, made them work pretty well, because on lap 15, he's still ahead. Now, of course, the drop-off kicks in, with these super softs being on them on, I think, on the 14th lap he is. So, we are definitely now in the process of being faster than him, and also being caught him quite significantly in the last couple of laps. And we are definitely now trying to make an overtake pretty soon. And you can see we are actually back into the points, P9, so it's not too bad. It's two actually behind us. So that didn't quite work out for him as we are running wide into the penultimate and last corner. Which we just misjudged that corner, and that means Jason will stay ahead of us for another lap, to say the least. And there's Stu actually also catching quite significantly behind. I'm not sure why he didn't stay out on the soft tyres, because most of the well, there's only one or two that actually started on soft tyres. Stu was one, Andre was one, and I think that was it, pretty much. Leobot maybe as well, I'm not too sure anymore. But yeah, not sure why Stu pitted, maybe had some damage as well. Can't remember anymore. So, we're now definitely again caught Jason within a couple of corners here. You can just see how much more tire grip we have over him here. Just weaving a little bit, trying to put him off, but I don't think it's going to work anyway. I just do that sometimes, not really to like intentionally distract someone. I just do it also to get a little bit more view of the track really in front of me, to maybe see some braking markers better, something like that. So that's why you sometimes do it on a short thread or something, just to weave a little bit and get new orientation points on the track really. So yeah, you can see in front of Jason though, there's pretty much not much to gain really. The field is quite spread out. I think the top three are pretty close together with Finn, Martin, and Sayaru. That's not so really surprising. The second half they have been equal on pace really in all the races. And now let's see if we can have a better run through these corners again, missing the apex a little bit there. But Jason is now pretty much very, very close to us now, and we are not getting him on this straight here, as we are now still in lean. But we are definitely trying to overtake him here on the next DRS straight. We are very, very close now. And the next corner is going to be crucial to make that overtake work up into P8. And honestly, after that damage in the first couple of laps, which lost us a huge amount of time and the front wing change, I would be actually happy with getting something like P8. But anyway, let's concentrate on this overtake here. Can we outbreak Jason on the inside of this corner? Yes, we do. And we also can run the car wide here on the curb, and that's us up into P8. So that's okay, I guess, considering the circumstances we had in the early part of the race. And yeah, the gap to Falcon ahead is quite significantly, to be honest. It is, I don't even know. But you can see on lap 19, you can see the raindrops are already falling. I skipped a little bit that from that one because, you know, there's not much going on, but it's very slippery now, and we're getting a warning for an off-track. I think at this point I actually got a 3-second penalty. I'm not too sure. Yeah, I think so. So definitely not to try to get any more of that. And here we go then into it. It's very cautious and going onto the intermediates towards to the end of the race. Let's see what the gap to RS Falcon is. It is 9.5 seconds. 9.5 seconds in 11 laps, I don't think that's possible. But if you're getting into the 3 seconds actually, if you have got more penalties than us, then that could be a chance to get another position. But other than that really, just important now to keep it out of the barriers. I've not done any wet practice in this on this track, I think. At least I think, yeah, I'm not sure anymore actually, if I did. But yeah, now task, keep it out of the barriers, and finish this race with some points at least to secure the championship thing. And also maybe actually we have the chance to overtake Leobot today in the championship, I think, if we finish 8th or 7th and he doesn't get any points, and currently he's I think 10th or something. And we're now skipping now further into this outlap on these intermediate tyres as we're now approaching down. No, that's wide, that's too wide, that's, we have just underestimated the closing speed, or just overestimated our braking power, and that is going to get us another front wing damage, and that means we will have to do 11 laps on this damage, which is going to be... I was really annoyed with that, because, you know, I just don't like driving with damage. No one likes to drive with damage, but to get it damage around a track like this, it's very easy, but also very harmful in many of the areas. But we're actually skipping to lap the last lap, and you probably were able to see gap to Falcon is 2.9 seconds. So for some reason we caught him. We were actually, the pace regarding damage was not too bad, and I think Falcon had some damage as well, so that definitely helped us as well to make up some time. And if we are staying in this 3 seconds, we have a mini chance to get another position if he has got more more penalties than us. Let's see what the gap is now, 2.8 seconds, so we definitely need to keep that in the 3 second window. And you can see also, well, here basically, we are now in heavy rain conditions, so we definitely also struggling with grip levels quite a bit, as you can tell. Here also, locking up a little bit into this Singapore sling, but managing to hit the apex anyway. And yeah, these conditions are very, very treacherous and very, very, very tricky. Flying Finn wins the race after, yeah, pretty intense race actually up the front, but he won it once again in front of Martin Ciario. Actually got a penalty, and you can see now gap to Falcon 2.2 seconds, and we should be actually fine to get into this 3 second window. So, and then just see if we pop up into P7 or if we stay in P8. We've definitely done our best after we got the damage. Really, I was happy with the last 10 laps of this race. Didn't go too bad really. And here we go, then only 3 or 2 corners to go, and you can visually see Falcon probably having even more damage in the last couple of laps here. He definitely lost a significant amount of time. He's running very, very wide here, but we are coming home in P7, which means Falcon got actually more penalties than us. And yeah, just finishing a minute behind the race winner is pretty huge, and having a gap to 26 seconds to the car ahead, which was Cyril Hamilton. So I think even if we haven't got the damage, I think that would have probably been the maximum I could have done today. So P7 is okay, I think, on this track really, and which I think means we will overtake Leobot question mark in the Drivers' Championship. He finished 9th, Jason not getting any points. I'm definitely concentrating on these two guys, and Mike and Andre, of course, as well. Andre actually finished 5th in this race because he did a one-stop. He's out on the softs and went on to intermediate straight away, so a very good strategy call from him there. Stu, unfortunately, retired after an incident. Not too sure which what actually happened anymore, but you can see in the championship, oh no, actually we didn't overtake him once. Surprise, sorry. Martin actually overtook Cupid because he had a race ban at Cupid after accumulating too many penalty points. And yeah, we are still in P9, but closing actually on Leobot and Jason, but also Andre is closing on us. So the battle for P6, 7 in the championship is not over yet. Definitely try our best in the next couple of races, and yeah, in the constructors not really much to see there. We are pretty much far down in 8th still, with maybe actually catching Haas. Depends on what Limitless does in the next couple of races. But that has been the Singapore Grand Prix. Not that exciting of a race, to be honest, but very, very intense driving, because it has been such a long race. Next track is going to be Malaysia, my favorite track of the calendar. Hopefully you'll have a great race there, and I will see you there as well. Bye bye.